Welcome to the channel. The One Research Foundation is a nonprofit research foundation that has been pioneering scientific research in integrative healthcare for three decades. One's mission is to advance mind-body healthcare through research, education, and service. The organization is 100% funded by passionate patients, practitioners, and those interested in mind-body research. The groundbreaking research focuses on neuro-emotional technique, or NET. If you're new to the channel and you've never heard of NET, click the link over here to go watch our documentary Stressed, then come back. When we use the terms mind-body or integrative medicine, we're referring to a holistic approach, which allows us to treat the human being as a single organism, as opposed to simply viewing health through the scope of mind problems and body problems. We recently traveled to Carlsbad, California for an NET seminar to speak with practitioners and board members and continue this exciting and important conversation.
What brings us all together, whether the mind or whether the body category? The NEC, the neuro-emotional complex, is the thing that we're working on. We're not working on anger. We're not working on grief. We're not working on paralyzed will. We're working on the NEC.
So the first time I saw NET, I was in chiropractic school, and it was Dr. Scott Walker. I saw him. It was clearly when I saw him in front of the room teaching this seminar that it was a calling. You know, this guy, like many great discoveries, awakened to something or something that we've all looked at 1,000 times, but he looked at it differently. And for the first time ever, I saw somebody not just talking about what was my experience, but they were demonstrating it, which was that at first, emotions seem to be physiological based, and our conscious mind needs something to talk about. So we're now able to talk about these things, but that's not where the visceral changes happen. The visceral changes happen in our physiology.
We will say things like, that makes me sick to my stomach. Or, oh, you give me a pain in my neck. So basically what we're saying is something psychological is causing physical distress. With the research, we're putting many different things out there in terms of treatments, potentially that may work, that may not. And NET is one of those treatments. And we are willing to take whatever comes in terms of what does the outcome show. And that is the same way I treat NET when I'm working with somebody is, It's them. It's not my best guess. Oh, this is probably due to when you were 2 and your father did. No, I'm not doing that. I'm really sitting back and going, okay, what has come up for you?
Early in practice, I just started finding that when I did more emotional work, people started feeling better without even doing the nutritional stuff. It doesn't mean you can't. You have to, you know, leave that out because we still need that part. But even like the structural things would get better after I did the emotional stuff.
What I like most about the One Foundation is that they're actually doing it. And I like that they're right on the cutting edge. They're funding, you know, pushing the envelope of, okay, we know this clinically, but do we really know it scientifically? You know, there's one thing, there's thinking you know something, but then there's, okay, let's put this thing to the test and find out if it's for real. And okay, yeah, let's just put our money up on the table and, you know, put our money where our mouth is, so to speak, and just see, does this do what we say it does? And it did better, exceeded beyond that.
Without the One Foundation and the research, I was always going to be doing something that was fringe and could be questioned. It was important to me to offer something to my clients that was solid, that was anchored in something solid, and I knew the research would do it.
President of the One Foundation, Dr. Melissa Carrick, sat down for several conversations throughout the summit. One of them was a lunch break with Dr. Kathy Goldstein.
I love the story that is about, you know, a teenage girl, and she's in the hallway in high school, and she sees her heartthrob down the hallway, and her heart's going, you know, her hands are getting sweaty, and her throat's getting a little bit dry, right? And clearly, from that perspective, yes, of the story, that she's, you know, she's excited and nervous and in love and has all of this heartthrob going on. Now, take those same symptoms, take the symptoms of having palpitations, sweaty palms, dry throat, and you're in the middle of the grocery store and it happens instantaneously. Now what are you thinking? Oh my God, I'm having a heart attack. You know,
or something anxiety is gravely wrong.
Yes, something is
even
wrong.
Even if it's in your daily life too, you're not necessarily doing it, but what sets off the the bell.
Exactly. And I think that kind of brings home that aspect of we may not be aware of our story or our outside world or our inside story, but our body is all the time.
As we learned in Stressed, the published research shows that NET helps improve connectivity between different parts of the brain, which allows us to pinpoint and address underlying stressors that are stored in our subconscious. Metaphorically speaking, it can be helpful to imagine our subconscious mind as a supercomputer, holding an incomprehensible amount of information. So sometimes our conscious mind can get lost trying to navigate through it. It's like having access to the internet but not knowing the correct URL. The information you need is there, you just need the correct location to find it. And that's where NET becomes a really powerful tool. Let's head back to the seminar.
And this chart, the reason I'm having this talk with you this morning is because my wife asked me to.
From the beginning, it seems like Dr. Walker always had this bigger vision. It's not just about Dr. Scott Walker. He always had this awareness, like, I won't be here forever, and I want this work to be here forever. So there's something about his vision of from the beginning to always want it to grow beyond him and stand the test of time.
We knew that the science was going to be there because the physiological measurable changes were there. All we needed to do was go through the motions, raise the money, do the studies, and now with the One Foundation and what's been going on with NET, the tail has wagged the dog, where I have been a part personally of all these different mind-blowing muscle testing-based techniques like applied kinesiology, quantum neurology, all these different things. So now all these techniques that preceded NET are now leaning on NET as the trailblazer of bridging what looked weird at one time to what is eventually, if hopefully sooner than later, become something mainstream for a lot of physicians.
Being a practitioner and you see it daily, you know, in your practice, and you see patients getting better and you see the results, but then now you have like a study that validates it, I think that's really important. But I think every person that we see is a clinical study, and we just don't have the tools or the finances to like publish it, or the means, or we don't know how, right? But now that you have this, it really just validates the day-to-day work that we do.
I'm seeing 21-year-olds coming in and going, what is the point? What is my purpose in life? And to me, to be involved in this is my purpose in life. And to be able to bring this kind of information to the world, that there are ways to create change.
The research gives the opportunity for educating. And that, to me, is primary. And that's what I look for when I read more about what the One Foundation is doing, is what is it? What is it that I can show as support for what we do makes sense, right, and is healing, and therefore will make for a better world.
So our mission is to lead with the science and let the science tell the story and the science of why it's important to us as practitioners. So the idea is if we can keep gathering together as a community, keep it going so that mission can continue to flow out and the people who really need us can get this kind of care, and so that we can have a different model of healthcare.
One stands for Our Net Effect. That's
yes.
That connection. We're here to, it isn't about the individual person, it's about the community and the tribe, and how do we move that ball down the road? How can we support each other? And in turn, how does that support our patients?
Yeah.
And in turn, how does that support the world?
Right. What we're really doing is we're researching hope, and we're really, what we're giving our patients or offering patients is hope, and not a hope that's ill-founded, but a hope that is grounded in science of like, oh, we literally are changing the structure of the brain immediately.
And you just said it, it's about, we are bringing our patients hope, and it's about validating that
yeah.
hope for them and letting them come know that it's okay to have their emotions.
Yeah.
As a society, like you said, this is a new conversation.
I mean, that's really it. It's like, I want to evolve healthcare,
and get healthcare to change and to move and to be something that actually cares for the whole human person.
And then it's out of that service and wanting to give back. And I can only see so many patients in a week or a day. Whereas if I can be part of something that can bring this amazing technology to the world, as our mission states, through research, education, and service, then I can have a greater impact on the world.
Join us in part two to continue this conversation, where we'll be joined by a few new faces. Make sure you subscribe so you don't miss any of our new episodes. You can also follow us on social media. Links are in the description. Until next time.